Welcome to Powering Travel, a new audio platform brought to you by Expedia Group. In the travel industry, we're all very aware of the busiest seasons that attract travelers to our areas. You don't have to be a destination organization professional to understand that a snowy winter is ideal for the avid skier, and the summer is where you'll find beachgoers enjoying fun in the sun. Savvy destination marketers create strategies around the questions, what happens in the off-season? How do you get travelers to understand the many offerings in your area, even during the parts of the year that aren't as popular? Today, we're hearing from two French destination organizations with a longtime partnership and a shared goal, attracting travelers during the off-season. To be more specific, Atout France is the national destination organization of France, and Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur is focused on the regions of Provence, Alps, and Côte d'Azur. As part of the French Riviera, people flock to the area in the summer, but winter? That's a different story. Together with Expedia Group's Media Solutions team, these two partners created a campaign to drive more bookings during this time. We'll hear about their challenges, who they see as their competitors, and the various ways they made sure that travelers knew about everything the region has to offer. Our guests are Sophie Mandrillon from Atout France and Loic Chovelon from Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur to talk about the success they saw with this collaboration. Here's my interview with both of them. I'd love to hear from both of you about your organization's mission. So Sophie, let's start with you and Atout France. Tell us about that.
Atout France, it is a governmental operator. We work with French and international tourism stakeholders to develop competitiveness and attractiveness of France as a tourist destination. We work in several fields of expertise, such as observation, engineering, innovation, quality, and also promotion, of course.
Loic, tell us about the organization that you're working with and your mission.
Yeah, sure. First of all, welcome to Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur. We are a beautiful destination in the south of France. We are the first most visited destination in France just after Paris, and we welcome every year more than 36 million tourists for only 5 million inhabitants. So tourism is very important for us and represents approximately 13% of GDP. So it's quite huge and big activity for our destination. Our mission focuses on one end, promoting our destination brands worldwide. And in the other hand, another point important is that we have to preserve our natural setting. So that's a quite big challenge for us, because that means from chasing tourist number to championing sustainable tourism.
So it's my understanding that you two, Atout France and Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur, you've been working together for a really long time. Can you tell us a bit more about that partnership?
Yes, it's true. We've been working together for a long time, and particularly when it's come to promoting regional brand internationally. And this has become even more important since the pandemic, I would say, because we were aiming to accelerate the recovery of the business together.
Yeah, sure. I can precise that we've always worked together.
I love that. When did you start working with Expedia Group? How did that start to happen?
We start our collaboration with Expedia Group, began perhaps with Provence destination, especially for Provence destination, nearly 10 years ago. But it jumped to a new level during the winter campaign, the last winter campaign, 23-24. That was very important because the goal was to promote Nice Côte d'Azur destination in winter, and with Expedia providing cruising insights and marketing channels that helped boost reservation by over 20%. That was amazing. And I'm really happy to speak about that, because during the last winter season, that was for our first year of collaboration on this unique strategy.
Atout France began working with the Expedia Group in 2018. So with a collaboration actually with Provence as well, the Loire Valley also, and Brittany. And we really encourage interaction and co-investment between institutional and private players in order to maximize the budget and also the visibility. So this is something really important. And Expedia has naturally emerged as a partner of choice. We have been growing through the partnership year after year.
So as you started to explore this engagement with Expedia Group. What kind of challenges were you facing when you started working with us?
Initially, hotels were really skeptical, fearing the campaigns would benefit Expedia more than their own businesses. And that was a real challenge to change this image 10 years ago. However, today, the results have proven otherwise. Now, many hotels actively participate and recognizing the campaign's value and our collaboration. That's also the result of your sales team, who is in our territory all year round. And that's one of the big key for Expedia, I mean.
So super accessible kind of relationship with Expedia Group. How about you, Sophie?
On our side, we were willing to transform our action to include more digital media plans. So we also need to have good advices to increase direct results on the campaign we were leading with measurable KPIs. And Expedia provided us with such data, which was super interesting. We were looking also for data to better understand the customer journey. It was one of the challenges. It's still a challenge, but we are able now to react quickly to the needs of international markets. And especially, it has been precious in times of crisis. It's been helpful since we've been through quite a lot of crisis in the last years.
I want to dive a little bit deeper into that aspect. What type of travelers are you trying to attract? And are you able to easily reach these kinds of travelers today?
Yeah, I think that is a big key point with Expedia Group. When we can analyze together the global markets, then use fine-tuning on the travelers we really want to focus on. And we know that is a big work for you to check all this data. And I'm sure that you are one of the only partners worldwide who are so clear on this data mining and data supply.
How about you, Sophie?
It's true that in France, we have a lot of destination. We have a highly segmented approach because we have to deal with different markets, seasonality, with different destination as well. So it's important for us to find the good contact, the good customer to address, and Expedia allows us to target audiences with a high degree of granularity. So that's perfect for us.
That's great and super important, I know, for many of our listeners too. I know there's a big focus on sustainability. Can you give us some more background on how Atout France is focusing on sustainability?
After the COVID crisis, the pandemic, there was an ambitious plan that was launched to accelerate the recovery of tourism, but also its transformation. It was an important matter with the main objectives of becoming a reference in terms of sustainable tourism by 2030. So this is one of our main ambition, and it is also to contribute to the development of a more balanced tourism. So this means that we need to work by bringing together and promote destinations throughout France, and also highlighting off the beaten tracks destinations, and also to reduce seasonality and spread tourist flow more evenly throughout the year. And in France, it's true that we are lucky enough to have a very complementary range of activity with the coast, big cities, vineyards, summer and winter mountaineering, little villages, a rich heritage, facilities also for hosting professional events. So we are lucky, but it means also that tourism can be enjoyed all year round, but there are still progress to be done. And we're trying to encourage stay all year round, especially in the wings of the summer season and also in fall, autumn and winter. So we're working in partnership with other regions to attract visitors. We're able to travel out of season and especially international visitors. And we also want to increase the length of stay, improve the quality of the experience, and also the increased revenue at last.
Sounds like you've got so many offerings in France to be able to market and work with organizations to create these campaigns for those off-season, shoulder season opportunities. Loic, what are your top priorities for Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur?
I can say, first of all, is we must show that we are a unique destination which offers an amazing diversity of landscape and activities in a very short range. And it's quite not well-known worldwide. For example, most of our long-haul customers think that they must take a flight to move from Provence to French Riviera, I mean from Marseille to Nice, but in reality, it's only 2 hours drive time. So we have to show that and explain that in our destination, we can practice ski during the morning and during the afternoon scuba diving, and the day after move on a big city. And it's very easy for that. In the same idea, it's very difficult for us and for our customer, to guess that they can land in Nice and Marseille airport to connect to our ski resort. And we have a big challenge because in 2030, we will welcome the Olympic Winter Games that was just well announced a few weeks ago as Salt Lake City in 2034. So we are waiting for Expedia to help us to explain that you can land on the Mediterranean Sea, but also go to practice ski. The second point for our priority is reducing seasonality. We need to promote tourism in fall and winter. Historically, the tourism was born in France 2 centuries ago during winter, and everybody forgot that. So today we start with Expedia, our new strategy to push that, with the campaign which is called Winter is the New Summer. And the region offers a unique combination of sunshine, culture, and events during the winter season. The third priority is also to attracting high-spending international travelers, because in Provence, and especially in Côte d'Azur, we have a lot of 4 and 5 star hotels. That's not the local market. So we use Expedia data also and Expedia targeting to be better on high-level spending international travelers.
And what are the key challenges that you face to deliver against these goals? Like, what type of competition are you facing in the market? What is that looking like for you?
The key challenge was overcoming the seasonality issue and position the region as a year destination. If we focus only on Côte d'Azur in winter strategy, our main competitors are other French destinations and European destinations. But if we focus on the US markets, Nice competes with destinations that provide warm, sunny winter escape. So that can be Latin American, Caribbean. But however, our strength lies in the unique diversity of our region, where mountains and sea, city and countryside are all within close proximity. And that's really the terms we want to push all the time. We are all year round destination, and we are sure that not a lot of other destination gets this lucky.
And Sophie, how about you and Atout France?
Yes, on a national level, I would say we have a lot of competitors because France is number one in terms of visitors. So obviously we need to remain competitive to stay number one. We recently conducted a survey of nearly 20,000 international travelers in 30 markets to understand their perception of France as a destination. And we found out that Spain and Italy have assets on which we are challenged, such as culture and heritage, natural site, local gastronomy. So we really need to work hard to maintain our market share and stay competitive.
Yeah. So what would you need to be successful in achieving those goals?
I think we need to encourage good coordination between tourism players at all levels, including tourism organization, but also the private sectors, the professional, so that supply really does match demands. That's something important, and you can help us on both sides. And we need to work on a strong differentiation as well, based on a main asset, French art de vivre and culture in priority, to preserve nature, an offer that innovates and transforms itself through investments and that make commitments also in terms of sustainability.
So tell me about one or two challenges that you were facing before working with Expedia Group Media Solutions, and how did those challenges affect your business?
I think the big point was we lack the data-driven insights to effectively target key markets. And Expedia Solutions help us understand booking behavior, and that helped us build a dedicated strategy. The campaign not only boosts in booking, but also highlights key themes like culture, heritage, and events, along with gastronomy and city breaks. All of them were already associated with Nice Côte d'Azur as a winter destination. And and this result is, it's because we get the good driver, the data driven, produced by Expedia.
Sounds like those insights are really helping guide the direction that you're taking, and that's great. So what did you find about Expedia Group solutions that were particularly interesting or relevant for your destination?
I think the ability to access real-time data is really important, and insight on travelers' preferences was particularly valuable. Expedia's social listening helped us tailor our messaging to focus on lifestyle themes like gastronomy, which is really relevant with our target audience.
Yes, I agree. One thing important also is the fact that we are able to work with multiple brands within the Expedia Group. And it's a good option for us to find better option in terms of targeting, depending on the result we are looking at. The group is having an international presence, and it helps us to have a multi-market approach in link with a network of offices all around the world.
What challenges did our display advertising solution help you to alleviate, and how did you measure these changes? So did you feel that our solutions helped you drive awareness for your destination? What did that look like for you?
Yes, we made a small total, but together we delivered over 400 million impressions last year while we were promoting France together. So it means that it was 20 campaigns that were lead on more than 10 different markets. Half of it were on the UK and US, which are a focus for us, and two main types of visitor we are targeting. But it's important to see that we had a strong presence on Expedia Group last year, thanks to the campaigns that we were leading together. 100,000 of conversion. We can see two-digit growth in most activated markets. Conversion and growth is not our only focus. So it was important, because we were working also towards seasonality, to see that there was some quality KPIs. So we've seen a positive impact on the length of stay, for example, and the seasonality of booking as well.
Yes, and for our destination, Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur destination, the campaign generated 153 million impressions and led to a significant rise of booking, with, for example, more than 3,000 flights and more than 6,000 rooms nights reserved during the winter season. So it's quite interesting to get this big key when we have to have a report with all stakeholders who put business with us in that, with Atout France also. It's really important today for us to convince a maximum of hotels to dedicated a specific offer during the campaign. It's not only to get a very lower price. That's not the goal. The goal is just to be attractive, to be better than hotels in other destinations. So today, it's very important for us to convince hotels to really prepare dedicated offer during the campaign, because their results will be better. And that will be a better result for the campaign and for all the investment we are also doing, the destination, Atout France, and all stakeholder involved in the investment of the campaign.
Yeah, that's amazing results. So outside of the campaign results, I know we were talking about, you know, the very specific KPIs and around seasonality. Were there any other success metrics that you could share with us?
Yeah, I think something important. If we are moving out of only number of rooms and number of nights and number of flights, something important is to speak about seasonality. And on seasonality, especially on this winter strategy with Côte d'Azur, we were really happy with a higher growth during winter by approximately 20% year on year versus 7% overall. So it's quite an amazing result for this first year we worked on this strategy. And we expect a lot more because this strategy was not just like that for one campaign or one thing, but that includes a long-term strategy. And so we have signed with Atout France and with you for two or more years on this strategy. So it's quite interesting to be better next year and the year after, of course.
We've talked about your current goals, so let's take a look into the future for a second. What are your goals in the next year, 5 years? Can you give us an idea of what the future holds?
By 2030, we want to become a reference in terms of sustainable tourism. As I was mentioning, we want to take into account visitor satisfaction, acceptance by local residents, and also to take into account the economic impact, but also the impact on resources to develop a more balanced tourism.
How about you, Loic?
Over the next 5 years, we aim to establish Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur as a leader in sustainable tourism in Europe and fostering a balance between economic growth and environmental responsibility. And I hope this target will be mixed with Expedia also. And if in 5 years, we are the first destination on environmental responsibility and sustainable tourism promotion, I'm sure that will be better if Expedia Group is also the first group in the world really engaged on this direction. I'm sure that we can build that together, Expedia Group, Atout France, and Provence and Côte d'Azur destination.
Thank you to Sophie and Loic for taking the time to chat with me and sharing the results of their campaigns. As you can see, for destination organizations, getting in front of the right travelers can be a challenge without the right data, tools, and resources. Expedia Group's media solutions can help bridge the gap to make sure your off-season strategy is a strong one. To learn more about how media solutions can support your destination organization, visit the link in the description or reach out to your account manager. Thanks for listening to Powering Travel, brought to you by Expedia Group.